is demanding. It says challenging yet obtainable objectives. Now, this is one that's really interesting because we like to stretch. And in your organization, you really like to stretch. If you're getting a high score on this, it means you're stretching me, you're challenging, but it's obtainable. It's a doable thing. So you're getting the maximum motivation from me in order to do that. And you're really bringing out the best in me, and you're really going to get the most extra effort, and you're going to get the best out of it. If you're getting a low score on this one, then what's going to happen is you're going to demotivate the organization. They're going to stop putting in an extra effort. Some of the common things people do is whatever the objective was last year, whatever we hit, increase it by 10%. If you're increasing it too far, you're stretching it too far, the motivation of it goes away. Watch this. Each organization goes out and they set their targets because they take performance and then they say, we need to beat that performance by this amount. And they set a target up there. This is what we need to achieve. And then what happens is that target was above anything else they've delivered. So in order to hit that target, they actually have to set production records in order to hit that target. And then what they do is they say they color code it. So they say, here's the stretch target. Here's our budget. Anything underneath that budget is red, unacceptable. I'm pulling out my hair. I'm going, are you kidding me? So you're trying to tell me that if that organization does a performance record, so this is the best performance you have, it's red. Technically, with the best performance you have, I should be walking into your organization and saying, I am really upset with the performance that you're having because it is unacceptable. And the operator looks at me and goes, it's a damn performance record. It's the best we've ever done. It's in the red. That's what they do. And it drives me absolutely crazy. I mean, I'm saying, stop that, manager. Stop doing that. You're putting pressure on your people. And what happened was is they had these big signs on the doors, big charts on in the hallways. Like when people walk in the factory, you're going to see the hallway and shoot, we're red again today. We're red again. And they would walk in tomorrow doing a good performance, maybe even what I would think is excellent because it's a record day, and they're in the red, and I'm in the red today. And they come back in, and I'm in the red today. And they set those objectives really hard, so people come and say, I'm in the red today. So what do you think happens? They stop performing. Then, so performance came down, and then we had to come in, and performance started to go down, bump, 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 and it got stuck down. So then all of a sudden, we had to do some really powerful motivational speeches and kind of spin this thing around. And all of a sudden, performance, just like the next day, we did the speech. The next day, boom, it came back up, and it was back up. Then I said, you can't do this to your people. And they said, in January, we're going to set new targets. And when we set new targets, we're going to make the colors correct. So I go, you got to stop this. People, please, you're demotivating your people. Your targets are so high that they're unacceptable every day. How motivating is that? We come back in January, and I look at the charts, and my stomach turns. They set the targets higher, and it's red. I said, how can you? It's red. They set a performance record. It's red. And they started driving the organization to the red. And the organization went just like this. The performance went just like this. Boom. And it dropped like a rock. I mean, the whole company went down. The whole company drops. And I forget the exact degree of the drop, but it was huge. Because let me ask you this. If you're going to be unacceptable anyway, why should you put in the extra effort? It's going to be red anyway. Why should I? So you know what they did? It was an operator's answer. They didn't do this exactly, talk about it, but this is the way I visualized it. The manager said, here it is. Here's your objectives. They're red. And the operators went, that's what I say to you. And they just dropped performance. And then the performance dropped right out of the floor, right out of all the managers. And now all the managers are panicking. All the managers are panicking because now they're high level over here that they had, that we could have achieved that. If you put that in the blue, I think we would have motivated to achieve that. By making that red, they just went boom. And then all of a sudden, the gap between where they were performing and where they were was huge. We put a 1,300-person factory we dropped their performance, and I think it was for about 6 months or so. I don't know, I have the exact figures, for one reason, because they did a very bad job at this. They set the expectations so high, they made it so challenging that factory just dropped the performance right out from underneath their feet. And then you got to work like hell to bring it back up. I go red in the face when I see this. I go crazy with the leaders who say, just add 10%, that's the budget. If you don't hit the budget, it's red. I've got pictures of graphs, one after the other one, where I put a point on it and I say, people, that's a performance record. A performance record. It's in the red. How can you do that to your people? Rule number one, if it's a performance record, it's in the blue. I don't care what your number is. If it's a performance record, it's in the blue. Records are in the blue. Highest performance has got to be in the blue. Oh no, I set that really tough target, and if it's underneath that budget target, it's red, it's unacceptable. Well, you shouldn't be setting that target. And you shouldn't be doing that to your people. So you need to make a big difference between setting your challenging target and calling it red for your people. Because I will stand up and defend every single team member there is when you make that mistake of calling a performance record red. It's so demotivating to your people. And I can give you other stories of departments that have dropped, where performance just drops because the people just stop. They say, I'm not giving you extra performance, and they stop. And when they do this, performance just dunk, and it just drops. And I look at the manager and go, well, what do you want? You caused that problem. You demotivated them. Please be careful with your colors, because that is really bad. And unfortunately, that is a common mistake that we make, and we think it's okay, and it's really not okay.